blessing. This is Pastor A.K. Parham. We welcome you into another Bible study. So we give God the glory and honor for who he is. And so we thank you for tuning in. We thank God for putting on your heart to tune in to the IAP Bible study tonight. And so the I is always in our Bible study. And so even the mission and the vision of our church is empowering to be a blessing to those in our community. And the I is for definitely, we want to invest in others. The A is for action through ministry. And for me, P is for promoting unity in our community. And so just like many times before, we like to open up with a word of prayer. Let us bow. Dear Heavenly Father, we ask in God tonight that you'll bless, God, that you'll speak in a mighty and magnificent way, that you'll move, God, and that we feel your presence, God, as we go forward in this lesson tonight. We ask, God, that you continue to inspire, continue to uplift, God, continue to encourage, God, tonight, continue to allow your truth to come forth, God. I pray that hearts are open, minds are ready, and we are receptive, God, what you have to speak in this hour to us. And so move, God, and bless God in this time that we're going to share in this Bible study. So we give you glory, we give you all the honor, and we give you all the praise. Amen. God bless you. And quite like it's definitely our hump day scripture comes forth. Our hump day is designed, amen, to help us to get over the Wednesday hump. And also it tools us with a word, amen, that we can have in our heart. And then it also allows us to minister to those that are around us, amen, in the season. And I just believe that if we, as a church, as a body believer, I'm a part of those who are connected to us, once we read it together or read it on Wednesday, we believe no matter where you are that it can supernaturally connect us and put us all on the same page. And going with that, if you'd like to partner with us, you can go to www.imapartmbc.com and you'll find all your online giving options as well as viewing options. Or you can write to us, P.O. Box 2772, that's P.O. Box 2772, that's West Memphis, Arkansas, 72301. And so wonderful, this Sunday we had a phenomenal time, and also we had opportunity to go out to 8th Street Mission, which is in West Memphis, Arkansas, Broadway or Highway 70, and at the corner of 8th Street, amen, with Pastor Brown, who was able to give donations to them, amen. They were looking for women and men clothing, extra larges and or higher. And also, we was able to contribute a little bit financially. We want to support the store and the men over there that are doing some great things and transforming their lives. And so if you'd like to partner with us, or you can just go straight to 8th Street Mission yourself, amen, and be a blessing to them. And so we thank God once again, amen, for another night. And so as we move our hump day scripture, comes to us, amen. Our hump day scripture comes to us, and from the power of God, and we thank God, we believe it, 1 Corinthians 2 and 5. So that your faith would not rest on the wisdom of men, but the power of God. So that your faith won't rest in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. Amen. So definitely as men and women of God, especially as preachers, amen, we definitely don't want people to be so caught up in us, in our word, in our philosophy on life versus what the Bible says and what the true unadulterated word of God says about issues and circumstance in our life. So we want to be true to his word, spreading the word of God, the word of God, the spirit of God, the power. That's where the power comes from, to change and transform lives. And so we want to give our own opinions, amen. And so we don't just want to encourage, but we want to inspire people to have a relationship with God, that spiritual conviction. And so definitely that is by preaching his word. His word has power. We trust the word of God. And so definitely, so flattery words, and we don't want to flatter people. We want souls to be saved. And that is through the spirit and the power of God. And so once again, 1 Corinthians 2 and 5, so that your faith would not rest on the wisdom of men, but of the power, on the power of God. And so as our Greek term of theology, we love that. We deal with our Greek term of theology tonight. Our Greek term of theology is agape. agape, amen, agape love, agape, empathetic, universal love, love, benevolence, goodwill, agape, agape. And so many times, the God, we understand agape is a Greco-Christian term referring to unconditional love. And definitely when God, that's the highest form of love, charity, and the love of God for man and for man for God. Amen. And so it extends even to the love of one's fellow man. And so we want to love and agape love. Amen. The universal love, love people. Amen. And try to operate and move in the spirit of God and to love people the way God desires us to love him. And so tonight we continue to further into our series, The Divine Link. We have three objectives that will help us explore and stay on track as we study our lesson tonight. And so those three on track, we ought to try to identify as we get ready to go to John 15, 6 and 8. There are three objectives that we will explore. Number one, we're going to identify the relationships in the link, examine the nature of the link, and analyze the critical connection. Definitely, we understand that we need to be linked to the vine. There's some powerful relationships that gives us the strength from on high. And so we need that in order for us to prosper and move forward on this Christian journey. Also, we examine the nature of the link, and definitely the resources that we need comes through this. It's a power source through God. Amen. It's a link through the relationship of Jesus Christ. Amen. Who is the true vine to the husbandman, who is God the Father. And we believe that the Holy Spirit connects us as the branches and allows us to have this beautiful connection, this link that we have with the kingdom of God. And then thirdly, we analyze the critical connection. Amen. It's critical because our lifeline is connected there. If we don't have that link with God, we will wither and be thrown away. But if we have that link, if we have that beautiful connection, then we'll be prosperous. Amen. We'll be fruitful, bearing much fruit. And so our focus scripture tonight is going to be coming from John 15, 6 and 8. If you have your Bibles, we're going to John 15, 6 and 8. It deals with it and it's let us know. And so we thank God tonight how much the word of God inspires and moves us together. Amen. And so we give him glory and we give him honor and we give him all the praise tonight for who he is. And so as we move to briefly to explore what it means that God is trying to speak to us and let us know that God loves us. Amen. And let us know that we can abide in his love and he loves us and we also love God and we keep us his commandments and we move forward and we love others. Amen. And it challenges us and it pushes us to love others and love others as the way Christ loves. Amen. That way God loves. Amen. That's powerful and that sacrificial love. And so it pushes us to the next level. And when our love for God, if we can only do that, when we link to the vine, amen. And so we understand that we remain in God. And when we remain and we're connected, we're linked, amen. That love is moving. God loves us. And we're loving God back and we're trying to love people, amen. And the way God has taught us and the way Christ is leading us and been a great example to show that he loves people unconditionally, amen. And so we strive to do better even with our love for one another. And the Bible promises in the scripture that if we love God, amen, and we remain in him and we love the way he's called us to love and that his spirit is leading us to love, we believe and we trust, amen, we trust God that our joy will remain full. Amen. He promises that our joy will remain full. Amen. And so we're strengthened by that. And we, men and women of God, we want to continue to walk the way God called us to walk. And so tonight, as we get ready to go into deeper into our lesson, definitely we looked at in our previous with the divine in the E, being earmarked, pretty much being set aside for the kingdom's use when we're linked to divine. And definitely execute, amen. We don't want to be executed, amen. We want to execute. That means we want to do some things powerful for God. We want to execute God's plan over our life and move in the way God desires to move. And we understand that we disobey and we disobey. Judgment day will be coming. One day we'll be executed. We'll be like that branch that is withered, that is picking up, that is tossed into fire, that is burned. And so definitely we want to execute for the kingdom of God. And so tonight we're dealing deeper in our E, and the vine is the expected. Amen. We're trying to see how what is the benefit? How is it benefited to the branch being connected to the vine and it's expected? Amen. And let us know, such as John 15:9-12 says, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Continue ye in my love. If you keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love. And even as I've kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that ye love one another. That's the test, as I have loved you. And then we think about expecting. Feeling or thinking that something will happen. Wonderful, expecting. Expecting something. It's like a parent expecting the birth of a child. And so we thank you, God, today that we walk always in expectancy that God is going to do something great in our life and help us to do something great for others because we're linked to him. And so definitely when we're linked, we understand that we are pregnated with the promise of God's love, which will manifest in his way of giving us a bundle of joy. Amen. And I thank God today that the joy let us understand the love of God in our life, and it keeps us lifted even when things in our life may be going crazy and hectic. So we got some synonyms that that we can associate with expecting, and that is hoping, being hopeful, waiting, anticipating, watchful, vigilant, and eager. And so we understand we operate in the love of God, and we're expecting because we're linked to the vine. That checks all the boxes, amen, that is categorized in this scripture and in this synonym that we read about expecting. And so we understand that love hopes, amen. So we expect it. Love always hopes. And so we thank God that we, because of the love of God, we're linked to the vine, that we never lose hope. And so not only understand that love waits, and so we expect it. So I believe I can be patient because I know God will fulfill the promises that he's given me over my life and that he's spoken over me. I believe. And so I can wait in hope. Love allows me to wait. Amen. And then we understand that love anticipates. And so when you love, when God love God and you love people, amen, you anticipate some good things are going to come out of this. Is anybody believing that God has some great in store, that good is going to come out of your situation, no matter how bad and bleak it may seem? And so love is watchful. I find out love is watchful. Love will keep you watchful, making and waiting and anticipating, waiting in earnest expectation of the return, or waiting for that communication. Love will keep you up at night waiting to talk to the one that you love. And so we understand love is watchful. Love is vigilant. Amen. And then we understand that love is eager. And when you love, you just can't wait to see them. You can't wait to spend time with them. It's something about that godly love that gives you joy in your heart when you're linked to the vine. The power of love that comes when you're linked to the vine, that's what it is, that the power that comes through the power of the Spirit. And definitely we understand that love, the book of Galatians tells us that love, amen, is a part of the fruit of the Spirit. Amen. And so we believe, and so we understand that God wants us to produce and be fruitful on this kingdom and bear much fruit. And we do this through the love of God. And we understand that we operate with a spirit of expectancy, believing and trusting God, he will do in our lives. That's why we can continue to press on through the hard time, because I'm expecting, even though it looks like I'm losing, I'm expecting to win. Amen. God is able. And I want to explore real quickly five scriptures that kind of detail the love and give you some explanation on how being linked to the vine and operating in that spirit of God and loving the way God wants you to love. Amen. And also having expectancy and being expected in your heart, and understand that God expects a lot out of us. Amen. As men and women of God, trying to live according to his will in his way to be able to bless the kingdom. Amen. And so we are ambassadors for Christ. And so we want to be linked to the vine in order to have good success on this Christian journey. And as we look at our next scripture here, let me provide move. We look, amen. And so we thank God. And so we see 1 Corinthians 13:4-7. 1 Corinthians 13:4-7 is beautiful. Amen. And so many of us have read it, we have recited, it has been said at weddings, amen, and thought in different areas of our life. And so this is beautiful scripture. It says, charity suffers long and is kind. Charity envies not. Charity vaunteth not itself. It is not puffed up. It doeth not behave itself unseemly. Seeketh not her own. Is not easily provoked. Thinketh no evil. Rejoices not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hope all things, endureth all things. So how did that play a part? I'm expected, I'm linked to the vine, and I'm operating in love. How does charity? Charity is love. Play a part. And so when you love, you are long-suffering. You go through some things and you hang in there because, once again, you're expecting that greater is going to come out of it. You're kind and you're helping folks and passionate. So something about the love of God in you makes you have a desire to love others and to help others. And charity, I'm not a hater. Just when I see you going higher, I don't want to pull you down. I don't want to talk about you. I don't want to knock you down because I don't want to be a hater. Because something about the love of God in me want to see you prosper and move to the next level. And that's when you're linked to divine expectancy. Because I believe the same God that did it for you is the same God that can do it for me. And so I don't have the envy in my heart for you when I'm linked to the vine. So I can celebrate with you when you have success. I can come to your party and keep you uplifted and understanding that God is in control. And so, not only, and we know that charity wanted not itself. It doesn't puff up itself. It's not big-hearted and I'm little you and big me. Amen. It doesn't seek her own. Amen. But it's willing to serve and willing to give. Something about love, when you operate and you're linked to the vine and you expect it, knowing that God can use you in any way to bless people in a mighty way. It's not easily provoked. Amen. You don't pull out, make me angry and pull me out of character because I'm operating the spirit and the power and the presence of love over my life. And I can do that because I'm linked to the vine. I think of no evil. Amen. Rejoices not in iniquity. I don't want to see anybody fail. I don't want to see anybody hurt. Amen. But I would want to cover them and bless them and pray for them and see them get back up again. And so many times in our society, we love pushing. We got so to the point that we love uncovering people. Amen. And hoping they fail. And so many times, that's not the love of God. We pray for one another, help one another, cover one another, strengthen one another. Amen. So that God can get the glory out of life and see a transformed life. And love, and it happens when we adopt that personality when we're linked to the vine and understand that we expect it. It rejoices in the truth. Love, love the truth. Amen. No matter what, tell me the truth. Amen. Love. And so, and it bears all things. Amen. Love allow you to carry some things and deal with some things and handle some issues and love people that sometimes unlovable and believeth all things. I believe God. The joy in our heart. Amen. Gives us strength to believe God. Hopeth all things and hope gives us, listen, so many times on this journey, people are even given, losing hope. They commit suicide and different things in our land, and because they're losing hope, they're walking away from God, walking away from the church, walking away from people because hope, they've lost hope. And so, but yet love allow you to hope in all things. And so when you're linked to the vine, you expect that I have a hope that I know that God will, and it endureth all things. I can press on. It's my love allow me to keep on keeping on because love is a lifter. And so definitely we want to be linked to the vine. And then also, second, Colossians 3:14, it let us know, and above all these, put on love, which bind everything together in perfect harmony. And definitely we want to be in harmony with God. We want to be in harmony with our family. We're harmony in our relationship, harmony in our church family, harmony in the, for the kingdom of God. We want to be in harmony. And so we walk, and so that's what gives you, when you're in harmony, your joy. The joy of the Lord is my strength, and I can stay and rejoice, remaining with God, because we're loving the way God's love, and we're linked to the vine, and I'm moving in a spirit of expectancy, and I expect God to do it, and I expect good things to come no matter what. Amen. And then we move on to 1 John 4:7-8. 1 John 4:7-8. It lets us know, dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. And definitely we believe that God is love, and we believe that when we're linked to the vine, that we're linked to that love connection. And that means that I can bear much fruit because I can love. I can win souls for Christ. Amen. I can show them love. Amen. I can operate in the spirit of love. And how many know that love draws? Amen. And so we thank God today that he can use us to bear much fruit in the spirit of God through his power because of love. He says, love people as he has loved us. Amen. And that means you have to make some sacrifices sometimes to make sure that people have what they need, amen, to give your best and give you all, and so not to be hateful. If you're hateful, amen, that's not a loving spirit. That's not from God, amen. And so understanding that we're going to be children of God, representatives for the kingdom, we got to operate in love, not puffed up, not I'm better than you and you lower than me, amen. That thought should not be able to take hold in your mind. You ought to be able to pull that thought of submission and push it down and understand that everybody deserves a chance, and everybody, God is not a respectable person. And so the love of God, we shed the love of God, and we move in honor of the love of God, and we love people, and we understand that this brings about unharmony, and we understand that God is love, and that we're going to move and operate like God. We'll operate in this power and the spirit of Christ, as Christ's disciples, as followers of Jesus, that love must be the part of us each and every day. And it can be that once we're linked to the vine. And then, fourthly, Matthew 22:36-40. Matthew 22:36-40 says, Master, which is the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus said unto them, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. And so that self, and so in this 2021, in this new age, amen, sometimes people don't really know how to love themselves, amen. But if you, and so that's where the connection, the link to the vine, the love of God comes in. When you love God first, God will give you the strength to love who you are. It's hard to love others when you don't love yourself. And so many people walking around hating who they are. And so they treat people the way they want to be treated, but they don't know how to treat themselves. And so it comes out the wrong way. And so the true love is linked to God. And when you link to that, have that relationship with God and put him first, amen, God will show you how to love yourself, because he'll give you that joy in your spirit when you're linked to the vine. And then you can turn around and share that love, true love, not the love on order, not that love, that reality type show love. Now we live in a reality show age, amen. And every day brings about a different reality for different people. But it's not but one true reality. Just because things on your side look one way, and then a person see things on their side, that's their individual reality. But it doesn't have to be your reality. The true reality is God. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. And I don't know that, you know, God, that we're in the new age. Everybody like to see people drum on TV and drama, but hey, I got my own drama. Amen. My own life is a reality show. I'm trying to hold on to nobody else's problem. Amen. I have my own. But so we trust God, and I move in the spirit of respect and say that no matter what trouble comes my way, that I believe that God will make a way out of no way. And so therefore, amen, the joy remains full, linked to the vine, and understand that he's a present help in the time of trouble, and God wants us to operate in love. So love your neighbor as you love thyself. You'll fulfill the law and the prophets. Amen. And that's what God calls us to do, to love, to remain in love, to follow the commandments of love. And Jesus says, love others as I have loved you. How would they know you are my disciples? Jesus has. Because we have love one for another. And so, lastly, Matthew 5:44. But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you. Oh man, that's hard. Love them. Jesus, you said, love them. You the true vine. I'm linked to you. And you want me to do what you have done for my life and love people. But I that ain't hard to love, because I can love people that love me back. But what about those that is unlovable, those that are not loving me? I'm trying to love them, but they're trying to hurt me on every hand. God, what should I do with them? He said, love them anyway. Amen. Love them. Amen. Love your enemies. Bless them that curse you. If they curse me, God, you really want me to speak a blessing over their life? Amen. And you understand that the Bible, one scripture builds upon other scriptures. See, when God, he says, vengeance is mine. We don't have to take vengeance on him. Amen. And God, he handles. He's the one that fights our battles. Amen. And so we turn over. All he asks us to love. Amen. And so when we love, we reap coals up on people's head. Amen. Understand that God, amen, knows how to handle those things and those people that we can't handle. He calls us to love. And when you love versus hate, then your joy remains full, but you can only do that, especially in this time that we live in, is when you're linked to the vine. So do good to them that hate you. Yes, that's contradictory to what the world teaches. The world says, get them. If they get you, you get them. Amen. You get them back. But God says, amen, even though they hating on you, still do good to them. Pray for them, even though they misuse you. Even though they scandalize your name, still pray for them. Because the love of God, the agape love, amen, we want to be lifted. But you have to, in order to love like that, in order to be fruitful, hopefully you can win some to the kingdom of God. Being fruitful for God. And the only way you can do that, my brothers and sisters, through midst of the challenges and hatefulness, sometimes people can place over your life. You got to be linked to the vine, because when you're linked to the vine, you'll feel the divine love of God transferring in your life, and you'll be surprised what you can endure, what you can overcome, what you can outlast when you're linked to God. Thank you for another Bible study. Thank you for tuning in. And so I like to say a word of prayer. Remember, expect that I'm living in of understanding of being expecting, knowing and hope that God is going to do something great, because I'm pregnant with his promises, and it's going to manifest itself in joy in my heart because of his love. And so tonight, let us pray. Dear Father, we pray for those that are hurting. We pray for those that are frustrated. We pray for those that are dealing with sick loved ones. Pray that you'll give them strength. I pray for those who are suffering loss in their family life. God, we pray that you'll continue to give them encouragement. I pray that you'll fill the void of a hurting heart. Somebody's feeling lonely and feel like they're in a disadvantage, feel like throwing a towel. I pray, God, that you'll renew their strength right now. Let them know that you love them, God. I pray right now for that one that may be contemplating suicide. We pray that you'll turn that around. Let them know that their life is valuable. And then, God, we pray that you continue to put your love in the hands of protection, all of our churches, all of our country, and all, God, all of our elected officials, God. Help us, God, be leaders, Christian leaders, believers, God. Follow your will, love in the way that you're desiring us to love, and living in purpose, God, and being that branch that is bearing much fruit for the kingdom. Thank you, God, for being allowing us to link to you. We love you and we honor you. We realize we can't do it without you. So we give you glory this day. In Jesus' name we pray. We love you. Amen and amen. God bless you for tuning in. We love you as well. Thank God for your First Lady Parham. This sends our blessings. I'm a part of our church family as a whole. We welcome you. So God bless you. May God bless you. May God bless you. It's our prayer. Much love. So in honor of social distance, let me give you a great big hug.